Hello, my name is Renica and I'm your Y-class instructor. In this video, we're going to talk about the payment gateways. So I'm going to show you the payment gateways that we offer, also alternative payments, how to create your own page with payment conditions. Just a quick reminder that we already have a video tutorial on how to create new pages. Also, we're going to see how to accept credit card or bank card payments with Stripe, PayMeAuthorize.net to check out, etc. There is the PayPal option to accept PayPal payments, also the BitPay to accept Bitcoins using BitPay, and there is the Surfinsta, the new payment gateway. Now, there is also the Bring Ads to Top feature that I'm going to show you, and the Featured Ads feature that we're also going to look through. Obviously, the payment gateway is the tool that transmits payments between the customer's bank and yours. So, without further ado, let's show you how to work with it. Now you go under settings and then you choose payment. This will appear. Now these are the payments configurations. Here are the general ones. Don't forget to set currency that your payment gateway will support. So in my case, I'm gonna leave it to US dollar, but just check out if it works for your payment gateway. Now down below are the feature ads, so I'm gonna start with that. You have to enable them. The feature ads will be highlighted for a defined number of days. It's up to you actually. It can be for 5 days for the price of $10, or I added another plan, 10 days for the price of $7. You can add another plan, or you can edit this one or delete it. It's up to you. Then you have to bring to top ads. You can enable this feature as well. It will bring the ad that the user paid the price for at the top of the listing. In this case, the price is $5. The currency is the one we set. Now below you have some information that you have to fill in. And then you have the alternative payment here. You can create a page. I've created payment options and conditions. You can do that by going under content, then pages. And then you click on create new. I'm just going to show you real quick how to do that. It can be payment options and conditions too. Some description, and don't forget to make it active, otherwise it wouldn't show. You delete all of the cash and go back to settings, payments. Okay, so now I'm gonna choose it as an alternative payment and you're ready. Okay, so below the general payment configuration, you have the scroll option. You can have the scroll pay enabled and save if you'd like to use it. Then you have the Stripe. You can get paid via credit card. You can also use a Stripe account. It's free to register. You can see how much they charge over here, 2.95% of any sale. Then you have to add the Stripe private key, Stripe public key, which will be provided after registering. You have a few requirements here. Then you can get a fee from each sale made by your customers using the Stripe Connect, which is something you can read about as well. This is the link to the Stripe Connect. You can activate it from here. Then you will just need a client ID get key, and then you can add some application fee as well. After saving the changes, this will become your payment method. Then you have the PayPal. You just have to enter email address where the payments will be sent. Don't forget that it has to be the one that you're currently using, because otherwise the payments will be sent somewhere else. You can enable the buy now button as well. Save the changes and use it. You have the checkout. You can get paid via credit card. You just need to register a checkout to check out. Then you will be provided with account number and secret word. There is the authorize. You can get paid via authorize account. You will need here an SSL certificate, which you can buy over here from this link. Have to register for US or Canada, UK or Europe. Then you need authorize API login and the transaction key. You save the changes and you can use it as your payment gateway. Next comes the PayMail. You have to register as well. Then they will provide a private and a public key, something that is really normal. Then there is the BitPay. You can get paid in Bitcoins, so you can accept them as payment using BitPay. You just have to register, and then you have to put the pairing code that will be provided for you. Have the PaySby. You can register at PaySby, and they will provide an email account, which you can use. Next comes the SecurePay, slightly different. Again, you have to register, but you will have a merchant ID and a merchant password. RoboCassa is for the Russian market, specialized in the Russian market. It's another payment gateway. You register, they will provide the shop identifier, passwords, and then you will need some addresses to fill. You save the changes and you can use it. Now, the next one is the Pago Facil. You can use it, CCLW. They will provide the information needed, they will provide it for you, and you just need some address, and you can enable the sandbox as well. This is another way. There are a few methods here. You can use somewhere with credit cards, somewhere with tokens or bitcoins. PayTabs is easy. You just have to register. They provide the merchant email and secret key. Same goes for the PayFast. Next, you have the Mercado Pago. Pretty similar. You can get your client ID and client secrets from here. Then you have to fill it. Now the Zenit. You have the merchant ID, the web service username, password. Also, you have to create the merchant name and phone. Then, by saving the changes, you can use it. The payline, pretty similar. And the new one, Surfinso, it allows you to put a Surfinso token as a payment gateway, as a payment method. Below, we have the prevent fraud. Now, this feature helps you prevent card fraud with FraudLabs Pro for Stripe to co-payment when authorized. They provide, after registering, they provide an API key. After saving it, it will help prevent card fraud from your website. So without further ado, I'm going to show you how the feature ad looks. Also, just going to go to my listing. Scrolling down, these are some feature ads. As you can see, it has the label, it's highlighted. These two I haven't featured them. As an admin, I can click on the ad, and now I will have the options, because we enabled them, to put the advertisement as a top or to make it a featured ad. So I'm gonna do both. By clicking on any of that, this will appear the checkout. Now, this is the price, and you can mark as paid, or these are your payment options and conditions. This is the little button that shows on the right. So I'm going to mark as paid. It refers me to this page. Over here, I can see all of the advertisements. Also, by going in your admin panel, by going under classifieds and then advertisements, you can see all of the feature ads by choosing this in the menu. These are all of your feature ads. You can edit or mark them as spam, mark as sold, deactivate, or delete. So let's go back. Okay, and now this ad will be also, I'm gonna make it featured. Okay. I have to mark it as paid. So this was the ad. I'm gonna mark it as paid. Okay. Let's go back. So let's go back to my website. Now I'm gonna click on the ad. Now I can make it also to go to top if I'd like to do that, or let's check out that it became featured as well. Voila. Now I'm gonna show you how that would look like. If you decide to make your ad featured, but with a user, with an user account. So really quickly, I'm gonna log in, and now as you can see, this is just an user's account. Now I'm gonna click on publish new. Again, let's say it will be some cars. The description has to be. Let's say red. Okay, I'm not gonna put any image, and I'm gonna put all this condition. So after clicking on publish new, you have this option to make the ad featured. So by clicking on it, of course it has to pass moderation before being published, but by clicking on go featured, this will appear, and because I haven't set any payment methods yet, I have only the payment options and conditions over here. Also, I can change the plan if I'd like to do that. But this is how it looks like if you're with a user's account. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope it was helpful. See you in the next one!